Dear Mom and Dad, Pat Hodges and I had a great time in Saigon. Since Pat speaks Vietnamese pretty well, I was able to find out a lot about the city. Did you know that Saigon is a lot bigger than Tulsa? Now we're back at base working with the Arvin Rangers I told you about last time. The South Vietnamese are putting together some joint operations with the Army against the VC. The Kong have bases just north of the city in an area they call the Iron Triangle. They used to grow a bunch of rubber and fruit trees up there, but after the French pulled out, it's mostly grown over and pretty wild. Pat and I help coordinate between the U.S. and local forces. Basically, we fly around in Hueys till we spot a base, then swoop in to raid it, round up guerrillas, and destroy their supplies. It's the only way we found to surprise them before they can run back over the border and hide. My group will usually land on the perimeter while the rest of the force hits the other side, and we round up whoever runs and roll up through the zone. I'm told that the VC always flee and there's only been a couple of firefights, but I promise I'll keep my head up. I've heard that one before. Anyway, I've got Pat to watch my back, and the Rangers are very good at what they do, so please don't worry too much. I'll write again next week. Love, Dean.
Roger. Amber 1, target 3,000 yards. Roger that, Amber. Got
you're goddamn right! Get ready to fuck up for your
touchdown!
Get some!
All right, men, I'm catching a ride out of here. Proceed to the rubber plantation and establish the blocking position. Happy hunting.
All right, let's move into the plantation. We have to set up that blocking position. This is their base of operations. We need to find and destroy their stockpiles of rice and weapons. Keep your eyes open.
Come on. infantry. We have a visual on the church. That's what Zeus has his hands full.
Stay here, we're dead! Stand down, you asshole!
Dear Mom and Dad, I just wanted to send you a quick note to tell you that I'm safe and sound. We hit a pretty big guerrilla base the other day, and they decided to stay and fight for once instead of running away. They were well supplied with rocket-propelled grenade launchers and hit our chopper, forcing us to put it down. My team continued on foot and ended up saving the bacon of another downed pilot and his crew. And those guys have pulled me out of the fire enough times to have earned the payback. Some of the Arvin guys are saying that it's a good thing the VC stayed put for a fight. Most of the time, they just run for Cambodia where we're not allowed to follow and trickle back in after a couple months. We always beat them when they stay put, but it'll be a long war if we can't stop them from bugging out. I heard Jamie's at Paris Island. Tell him to write once in a while. I know boot can be pretty tough, but he's got what it takes to get through. I'm sorry I can't be there for him, but he could at least send a postcard to say hello. Love, Dean.